Hello everyone! Hello everyone and welcome back to the HCW YouTube channel. My name is RateWrestle and welcome back to Twitch, where we are live and in colour and stuff like that. Unless you're watching us on YouTube, then we're not live and we're not in colour. How are you doing, DP?
I hate you so much.
What's wrong with you? What's happened?
Every damn time.
Every damn time what?
You start the video and I'm not ready for it.
You four times if you're ready.
But I'm alright. How you doing?
I'm good. I'm living the dream.
what dream is that?
This dream. Anyway, we are here to discuss Kamikaze Pro Live 45. So as normal, you'd see Alex Connors here, but Alex Connors isn't here because the man is busy as hell being in countries and weddings of redacted people and Comic Cons, I think he was at as well. And at one point, this video wasn't going to come out, and I realised I still need to do video. I can't be that guy that kind of just doesn't release stuff like DP does. So DP's here to do this.
What?
What's wrong, DP?
I release videos.
Where's Jeopardy?
One.
Where's Star Wars?
Okay, fine, two.
Where's Project Zomboid?
Okay, fine, three.
Where's the rest of the Uno?
Not my job.
Where's Jack and Box?
That says it's subject.
I feel like there's a lot of things I mentioned in one row there. Anyway, so Kamikaze Pro Live, I don't remember the day, so yeah, 17 days ago, nearly 2 weeks. Yep, May 10th, Kamikaze Pro Dojo, we were live for Kamikaze Pro Live 45. So it kicked off with Colin. So for anyone that's not aware, Kamikaze Pro Live shows are run by Carl, who is the GM of Kamikaze Pro Live, and Colin is the GM of the main shows. But Colin was there to announce something special. So everyone that was there would have noticed around the room, it was saying that there was going to be brand live TV going to be happening on Channel 4 for the Joe Lycett show.
Yes.
So Joe Lycett was filming live at Kamikaze Pro Live. I didn't stay because I'm that guy and I'd rather go home and enjoy my life. I'll be honest, I'm just not that kind of person. Like, it's cool, like, it's fantastic they got it. Obviously, it's got Kamikaze and live TV and stuff like that. It's just, I just wanted to go home and I live in Warsaw.
Yeah. It was Late Night Lycett on Channel 4, you said, which is hosted by Joe Lycett, who's a comedian. It's a very, like, a satire-y sort of show where he makes jokes aimed at various companies and the government, etc. And this time, he sent someone over to wrestling in Birmingham.
Yep, so because it's not on this review, we might as well mention it. Vanessa Fouts wrestled Man Like the Reese, beat Man Like the Reese, and I'm sure the title was on the line. And there's a picture of her holding the title, but nothing's been mentioned since. So I'm assuming Kamikaze just going to brush that under the carpet. or they might.
I'm sure if you went to, it's either the Wikipedia or the Kamikaze Wikia.
Yeah, it got changed on the Wikipedia at one point, yeah, but I don't think it got changed on the actual cage match. Colin did mention, I probably should speak about this on Twitter, but since nothing. So it's either it's never happened or Vanessa Fouts is the longest running Kamikaze Pro champion because you'll never lose it until she's vacated. but we'll kick off with the wrestling. So we had a singles contest with Ronnie G versus the Ring Gremlin. Have you had the pleasure of obviously you've not seen it live yet, Kamikaze. Have you had the pleasure of seeing what the Ring Gremlin looks like?
I have, yeah. I've seen the match with the buggers, with the chicken buggers.
Yeah, so Ring Gremlin is a person. He's not really. You can't really say he's a fan favorite. He's a heel. He's just mental. And obviously Ronnie G's beloved by the fans. He comes out to do Rick Astley's "Never Gonna Give You Up," that
Oh, hell yeah.
Proper does this and gets everyone involved. It's pretty much a cheat code and he knows what he's doing. So, Ronnie G matches always start off with a dab. So, Ronnie G, how long ago were dabs, DB? When was that around?
Fuck no, at this point. It's
probably a good probably five years ago, isn't it?
I'll say a decade ago.
So, yeah, Ronnie G's bringing the bat hard. he tried to make Chantel Jordan dab and the crowd didn't want it. They were just going, please don't dab, don't. And then she did it anyway. And then realized, and now he tried to make Ring Gremlin dab, but Ring Gremlin doesn't understand English, so he's not. He started doing this at one point, and it was a weird, weird kind of thing. Ring Gremlin was pretty much getting outclassed ring-wise because he's just a bit skittish, is probably the word to go with. That it's just confusing what's going on. He's like, he was trying to channel the fans in his own way, which is not speaking English, random John Cena signs, moves. Ronnie eventually got the upper hand and he was calling, so Ronnie is perfect for, he steals other people's moves. So he does the claymore kick, he does the people's elbow, but it's the people's dab.
Of course.
Yeah, he basically, but he's really good with telling you he's going to do it as well.
Yeah.
So he'll go, people's dab! And it's like, why is no one kicking out of this? but he did attempt it. Ring Gremlin kept going for like a Sister Abigail kind of position. Eventually, Ronnie just rolled him up to pick up the win. I rated 2 stars. It was not really for me. There was just too much randomness, and there wasn't really like a proper match. It felt like in the middle. It just felt like a lot of stuff was happening and nothing was like, it was just hitting in.
Yeah. But was there a celebratory dab?
No, I think so. But then the Ring Gremlin actually got really angry and started flipping chairs and stuff.
Ah.
So I think the Ring Gremlin's actually getting annoyed by how he's acting, and now he's probably going to be serious. Who knows? But yeah, I rated 2 stars. It just wasn't for me. It wasn't the goalie's best match that I've seen from both of them. Ring Gremlin said he had a fantastic match against Cheeky Little Buggers, where I think he was pretty much in his element with that. Whereas Ronnie, I feel like it was a bit of a struggle for him with this kind of matchup. We moved on, we had Will Stevens, who's been on the channel. You're aware of Will. He won a Wrestle Connect for you. nearly bombed the Wrestle Connect, but luckily he completely messed up the scores, so he threw the game, but he didn't actually throw the game, so that's good. So Will Stevens, part of House of Heritage versus Coach Mahon, the world's greatest sports coach. So, Coach always starts a match with a detention slip.
Nice.
So he always gives a wrestler a detention slip. He gave Will Stevens 3 detention slips over the last year. And each time Will Stevens goes, these are not real. Like, why are we doing this?
Will Stevens is that one kid in school who's trying to be cool and playing it off like, these aren't real. Who are you? What are you doing? Come on.
Real ODB. We're not in school.
Well, school was in session in the ring.
Good God. Anyway, some weird stuff happened. Kieran McQueen ended up in the ring, who's part of the House of Heritage as well, and he was second in Stevens for this matchup. Mm-hmm. Coach Mahon made him do push-ups, but instead of allowing him to do push-ups, he was putting his foot on him and slamming him down each time he did a push-up. And then Kieran just allowed this to happen, rolled out the ring. Stevens was obviously the more powerful guy in this matchup. He was hitting some great strikes, headbutts, chops, and everything like that. Coach Mahon is very much It's kind of like spurt, like a quick energy kind of guy. I can't think of the word where it's like a burst of energy kind of wrestler. He'll be beaten down and suddenly out of nowhere he'll do a few moves and then he'll get beaten down again. Energy kind of like Hulk Hogan-esque, McQueen then got involved again, but this time it was properly into Will's advantage, and Will did pick up a win. Will on a with a stalling power driver that Will's like he's perfected now. So he, for anyone that it is what it sounds like, he picks them up into a power driver, but he holds them for like probably about 2 or 3 seconds, then drops them on the nuts. I rate it 2.5 stars. It was quite short. There was a comedy element at the start, which I feel like, because the first match had a comedy element at the start, it just felt like, even though it's slightly different with the tension slips and the thing, it just felt like it was the same thing happening again. Stevens looked good with his strikes and so forth like that. Coach does play up the crowd very well. So the crowd are proper behind him. He's getting a better moveset week by week with a coach cutter, which is a DDP kind of variant. Kieran McQueen's hilarious outside the ring. He's just a funny guy. And the House of Heritage are doing very well, and it's nice to see them having a heel group, because I feel like people like Kieran and Steven and Sammy Hughes, who was the leader, I think he's technically the leader, I don't know if they're actually like got a leadership, were kind of getting lost in the shuffle, and I feel like this is a good move for them.
Yeah, fair enough. I've not seen much of Kieran McQueen, really. I've seen him do Ring Crew before, at shows I've been to. He's been crew at No Mercy, and also...
How was his ring crewing?
I mean, it was... He didn't stand out, so good job.
There we go.
But he was he made a mug out of by Luke Basham at Breathe. So that was fun.
Okay. Hopefully I'm going to Breathe. I think Frosty's coming with us.
Cool. I mean, I can't get to that one, but...
But there we go, at least HCW were there in some kind of force, so if DP can't get there, we'll get there. And yeah, so we move on to a match I was very much looking forward to. We had Nate Riley, the Rise of the Emperor tournament winner, came up short against George Lydon, last Kamikaze Pro Life, fighting man like DeReese, who had double duty that night, as we found out later. So man like DeReese is very much, he has a grudge against 2.0 guys. So. Okay. For your understanding, I don't know if you've watched our reviews with Alex and stuff like that. There's kind of like a 2.0 Kamikaze, which you like your JCs, your Ronnie G, your Ring Gremlin, your Coach Mahon, and then originals, technically Alex Connors, but he's not really original, but he's more in that mold. Luke Douglas, man like DeReese, Kieran McQueen, Sam Hughes, and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So he gets his back up in these matches, which I really like. So Nate's the quicker guy, but man like DeReese is a lot better technically sound than Nate at this moment in time. Because obviously he's more of a like he's more experienced than Nate. Nate's been around for a year, so man like DeReese has been around for about 6 or 7 years by now. So he was trying to just outshine him with technical wrestling. Nate was trying to outquick him with his big dives. Hit a few dives outside of the rings. He hit a few quick offense, so I've been told what this move's called every time, and I forget the name, and just make up my own name. He hits the cheeky 619, I call it, which is Will Ospreay does the cheeky Nando's kick. Nate Rowley does a version of that, but he hits a 619, which looks really good, really cool. And then he follows it up with a phenomenal forearm kind of dive off the top rope. Very good offense from this. Man like DeReese was trying to kind of overwhelm him with his power. They had a Suzuki-esque strike battle in the middle of this, just full on just hitting each other for ages. And then man like DeReese is getting like a Takeshita style out of nowhere. His usual finishes used to be like the 450 splash. Mm-hmm. He's just winning matches with random maneuvers. Like he hit like an end of days variant to beat Nate in this match.
Mm-hmm.
Just that, like it's just like he suddenly went like Takeshita doesn't win matches with the same move, does he? What I feel like man like DeReese is doing at the moment. He doesn't win matches with the same move. Same as Bryan Danielson for ages in AEW with different submissions.
I think it's a cool element
that he should get into.
Yeah, I think more wrestlers should do it though. Like it's good to have a finisher, a patented move to finish the move, but it's good when you have like a random lariat that ends the match because it catches you off guard.
As long as it's not silly, like they're not just like they've hit like 15 suplexes and a fisherman suplex wins it, because he'd be like, what? You know, like an end of days is a powerful maneuver, so it makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
I rate this 3 stars. It was the best match of the night so far. Nate's incredible in the ring. He's come on a lot since I first originally saw him when he came over. He's obviously he's been showing up at places like Hinkley and PWE, I think they're called. And obviously, man, like the races everywhere. And he can, when he wants to, he can put on a great match. Yeah. And this is one of the shows where he really wanted to put on a good match, and it was good.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah.
I don't have any comments for it. As you said, I'm not too familiar with the with Nate Riley, but Man of the Race, I've come to an opinion where I don't necessarily rate him as much. But obviously, I'm going to what you're saying, and it says it was a good match. So
yeah,
I'll take your word for it in this instance.
No, but Man of the Race has said he's very much, he can be hit and miss of the essence of, depending, if it's a big match, he'll turn up. Whereas if it's a dojo match, sometimes I feel like he's just run by paint by numbers, because one, he probably doesn't want to get injured, he wrestles so much, and two, it's not like he's not fighting someone massive when he's fighting like the dojo guys sometimes, but this one he put the work in, which you have to respect. Next up we have The Future Is Meow, which is Zach Walker, The Future, and Son Vu Ho, I think he's going by now. I keep forgetting Sonny's new name, because he suddenly changed it. Son Vu Ho. So he used to go by Sonny Noss, but he's going by Son Vu Ho at the moment. And they were facing, Alex Connors and Luke Douglas, but they will always be known as Team Hate Wrestle. so obviously, Alex Connors and Luke Douglas as a tag team were always going to be strong, in my opinion.
Yeah,
as we, because you know, no bias there.
No,
so Future Is Meow. I don't know if I've spoke to you about this before. Future Is Meow are very cat orientated. They meow during matches. Sunview Ho is awesome separately when he does the cat gimmick. Like he'll do stupid stuff. Like he'll get someone to rub his belly, but then he'll bite them. If there's a door outside, he'll try and get them to let him go outside, but then he won't go outside. It's funny, like that kind of flipping thing. But when, as a tag team, they're doing it all match, and it can get a bit like, okay. so this was a match I was looking forward to. I'm going to, the notes I've written here, as I said, I've shortened my notes rather than giving play-by-play. So cats can land on their feet. There was toys. There was cat toys. Dreamies were involved, because there's no other cat brand that Future Is Meow use. It's only Dreamies. There was a plushie. There's a cat plushie. There was tickles on the tummy. So this was the first like probably 5 or 6 minutes of the match of just random cat stuff. Then Team Hate Wrestle took over and actually started wrestling.
Super
kicks. They were working as a united team, which they are a team in Bridge Pro Wrestling, and they should be a team here because they can actually work together. The plushie hit dive. Then, Luke and Alex hit a few offensive maneuvers. Luke's been hitting the stroke, Jeff Jarrett's stroke. But yep. Alex hits his running knee at the same time, and it looks pretty cool. They do a chasing dragon variant, but it's the Crown of Thorns. Have you seen Alex's Crown of Thorns before?
I have not, no.
It's a suplex where he drops him on his knee. It's like Adam Cole's move, where it's like a suplex and he lands on your knee.
Yeah, it's like the Kingslayer that Spatch Ray does.
Yeah. So he calls it the Crown of Thorns, cool. His version of it. So they were working very well as a tag team, and I was actually getting the middle of this match I was really getting into, because they were making Future Is Meow actually wrestle rather than just all cat gimmicks. Like Sonny still was at points scratch people and stuff like that, because you know it's what he is, and I think it works for him, but then Zach is part of that tag team. Zach wasn't that at the start, and I think they're throwing him into it to kind of bring them together and make a bit of difference. But out of nowhere, Alex Connors gets DDT'd by a teddy.
Okay.
And loses the match.
Because of the DDT on a teddy bear.
So, basically, Song Fu Ho and Zach Walker, I said this is very, you need to watch it on demand, people, because this is very much, I'm streamlining these matches, so don't vlog. They like, hit a backcracker into a Swanton bomb, which is pretty cool. But then, I can't remember, all I remember is that Alex Connors is on in the corner, his head hits a plushy toy. The plushie does, it's literally a plushie that's that big. It's not like a, like that size kind of teddy over there. So it's not even like a Yoshiko DDT kind of thing going on. The teddy, Alex just goes with it and gets DDT'd by this teddy. And they pin him. That's the end of the match.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel.
Alex Connors got lost because of a teddy.
That's not a good look.
It's not, and do you know what makes it worse? Look, as I said, like, the Man Like the Race match was good, but this is the out of four matches, this is the third match that's just comedy orientated.
Yeah.
And like I said, like, I'm one of these people, I big up Kamikaze to the hilt. Mm-hmm. But like sometime like this was like obviously it might sound because it's got Luke and Alex in this match and I'm big, but it's just like when a man I never liked like the DDT Yoshiko beating people with flipping that thing or like Invisible Man winning matches and stuff like that. I've never been into that, and it just wow, like especially because that Luke and Alex are the experienced guys, they're the people that train these guys. They're the ones that, like, they're probably the best, biggest heels within Kamikaze Pro Live at the moment. There's probably not another heel I can think. House of Heritage are getting there. And then, just that match.
Yeah, I mean, to lose to a teddy bear, essentially, is... I don't know the word. It's kind of ridiculous.
Yeah, it's not the greatest, and it's kind of like, it just annoyed me. It's because kind of like Alex is pushing towards title picture, which we'll go on to, and it's kind of like he's the real world champion, which he technically is. And like, it's just. I rate it 2.75 stars, because the middle part of that match was very good. Like, if this match didn't end that way, I was getting to like 3.75 stars. But then that, it just out of nowhere, he lost to a teddy, and I was like, oh.
Yeah. See, I know earlier on we were saying that it's great to lose to something unexpected or catches you off guard or something like that.
Yeah, roll up or something like that, yeah.
But that is not what I meant.
Yeah, it just it wasn't a good point of the show. Yeah. It was down bad on that match. Next up, we have Chantel Jordan versus Alex Dean. So, Alex Dean is a new wrestler. He reminds me of Alex Turner from Arctic Monkeys. He has that style. He's look-wise, but he only wrestles in black trunks, so he's very like old-school Gabriel Kidd kind of vibe. He's very good with, he does cravats and stuff like that. He's very, very technically good. But he's got a manager that's a toy duck.
Okay.
So this is the fifth match of the show. And there's a toy duck plushie.
I'll just say Charles Crowley's got a toy monkey. I'm not gonna judge based on what someone has.
Yeah, it's just, as I said, it's just kind of like this is the fifth match and four of them have like thingy. So I don't know if you're aware of this, was originally supposed to be Alex Dean versus Samuel Hughes.
Yes,
but Samuel Hughes has anti-dephobia.
Oh, the fear of ducks.
Yeah, he's got fear of ducks, so he couldn't wrestle in this match because of the plushie.
Isn't that triskaidekaphobia? Or that 13?
You're thinking, yeah, that's 13, because I've literally had to Google the word anti-dephobia or whatever.
Oh, fair enough,
But yeah, so Sam Hughes couldn't wrestle this match because he's afraid of ducks, and Alex Dean's manager has a license, and it's a plushie duck. Wrestling-wise, this was good, though. There was a bit of comedy elements, as I said. Chantel obviously is legit, so she's kicking the crap out of him. She punts the duck in the air, which is what you'd expect from someone like Chantel. It's, you know, I don't want to messing around, like joking around with this duck, pretending it's real. She just punted it in the fucking sky.
Yeah.
She was absolutely brutalizing Alex Dean. He at the start of the match, he gets people in. It's funny. This is one of the funny bits I like. He chain wrestles, but then he gets them in like a tango dance move, right. Which I think it's just like when you do something like that, it's more of a what the fuck is going on, and the wrestler is disorientated more, kind of like what's happening.
Yeah,
which I do like that kind of offense.
Mm-hmm.
He threw the duck in the air at one point. And then did a running Basaiko knee, so that worked because it's kind of like what the fuck you did, and then it makes sense.
Then
he got into a cattle mutilation. Love a cattle mutilation. Wrestling wise, Alex Dean is going to be a guy, if I can get past the duck. Alex Dean is going to be someone I'm going to really enjoy. Character wise, he's funny. Like, it might have been on this show, it would have been just because every other match had called me elements. If it was just that and the duck, I probably would have got over it, but it was just every match. Chantel then realised she was in a bit of a battle, so she kicked his head off and won the match. It was like, she suddenly decided, I'm done now. Roundhouse kicked his face off. Picked up the win. I rate it 2 3/4. It was a fun match. Out of the comedy matches that are on the show, this is probably the best one because there was legit wrestling involved in most of it. Mm-hmm. Alex Dean is very good. I'm probably going to hype him to the hilt. Chantel was always good. She's probably one of my favourite UK wrestlers. Because she just beats people up and it's fun to watch.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think it's also just a testament to how good Chantel Jordan is as well. And obviously, this is not a knock on Alex Dean or anything like that, because as far as I'm aware, he's quite new to the scene. Like, in terms of being a wrestler and his experience, he's probably quite inexperienced in regards to just everyone on the card. To go get someone like Chantel and to have, you know, in your ratings, you know, a strong match, you know, it says a lot about Chantel, who's able to, you know, essentially not carry but put on this really good match.
It wasn't even that. You said she didn't really need to carry it. Alex Dane's been pretty good in his first two matches, I've seen.
Mm-hmm.
And he's fighting Sammy Hughes at the next show. So, do you know how that came about?
Did Hughes come out and declare the duck is, like, the duck ain't got a license or something like that, and then I can't be there?
So, Sammy Hughes came out and attacked Alex Dane with the House of Heritage.
Okay.
And then they concertoed the duck.
I hurt myself today.
Hey, you. Yeah, you. Do you like this video? There is a button. It's a very sexy button. It says subscribe on it. I wish I could click on it, but YouTube won't let me. Damn fuckers.
Nice.
The concerto today.
Lovely. I'd
love to see Sammy Hughes in the biggest, baddest like group that's going at the moment, Kamikaze Concerto the Plushy Duck.
Hey, you know, you've got to do what you've got to do.
God damn it. That was like, God damn it. Anyway, main event time. Edgar Adams, the number one contender, versus George Lydon, the ever-present Kamikaze Pro Live champion, beat everyone. Probably one of the best wrestlers in the UK right now. Absolutely incredible, George Lydon. So Edgar started this match by he is a lot quicker than George Lydon. He's the speed demon. That's what he does. But George had a bit of enough of it, and he was just hitting with chops and strikes and chopping him outside the ring. George got thrown into a wall outside, so it became a bit more scrappy. Out of nowhere, Edgar Adams hit the Burton Destroyer. I think he's from Burton. I can't remember if he's from Burton. It might be Nate Rowley, and I might have botched that. Oh, no. No, 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 no. Well, according to Cage Match, he's from Birmingham. He's definitely not from Birmingham. Anyway, doesn't sound right in my head now. I do apologise, Edgar. Yeah. No. I called it the Burton Destroyer. We're going to continue with that, even if it's Nate Rollins from Burton. We'll go from there. So, he hit a Destroyer out of nowhere, and he proper like, lampooned George. Like, George was out of it for a little bit, which was cool to see. They then went into like a hockey fight where they like the Sami Zayn, Kevin Owens just brawling the crap out of each other. Lydon is in his All Japan era at the moment. He's hitting lariats, doctor bombs, flying headbutts. Like, he does a proper insane flying headbutt where it's like, obviously kamikaze rings are not massive anyway, but like it's like Edgar will be one side of the ring and he'll fly and bug headbutt from the other side of the ring.
Yeah.
And it's proper like old school like Dynamite Kid flying headbutt where there's no protection. He probably shouldn't be doing it, but he's doing it. Both men were hitting massive near falls at this point. Tiger drivers by George, Edgar hitting a Destino, which he's kind of got involved with at that point. George had a bit of enough at this point. A massive lariat of out of nowhere hit a Tiger driver for another near fall. He hit an Avalanche Tiger driver. He hit the Misawa kind of one where you drop them on their head kind of thing as well.
Oh.
At one point. But then, out of nowhere, they're battling at the top, and George takes a top rope destroyer, followed by a Destino, which was more of a like tombstone Destino. As in, like, George landed, flipped, it was insane. Followed by two frog splashes from Edgar. And Edgar's the new Kamikaze Pro Live Champion. What a match this was. Obviously, this fucking... I've picked out the best moves and this doesn't do it justice. I read 4 3/4. This match was incredible. There was a standing ovation. They did the good old-fashioned... All the baby faces came out and fucking held him up. And the pain... Oh, it was so good. George obviously got on the mic after his 5,000-day reign and told him, you know, I've had the best matches when I'm with you and, you know, I'm gonna have, when I come back, I'm going to have another one with you at some point. It was... It really unstoured me on the show. Like I said, like the show wasn't bad. Like there was no real bad ratings. Like there was a 2-star in there, 2.5 stars. But this kind of pumped me for the end of the show, and I really, really kind of really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Just a fantastic match. But every match Edgar's had with George has been incredible, and it's nice to see a new champion at Kamikaze. Because George has pretty much ran through people, and he was getting to a second loop of people, and you get to a point where you know someone needs to kind of drop the toll, or you need to turn. He needs to turn on the fans and start facing the other people. But yeah, it's going to be fun to see Edgar have his moment. Next show up, he's not defending the title though. It's himself and Nate Riley versus CPF.
Okay.
Yeah, on a Kamikaze Pro Live show.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Which members is it from CPF?
I think Danny Black. Is Danny Black or... That doesn't sound right, mate.
He's from CPF, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it just didn't sound right.
Yeah, it's him, Joe Lando, and Maverick Mayhew.
Me, Joe Lando, yeah. It's not Maverick Mayhew, no. Yeah, I remember Maverick Mayhew. Yeah, so it's him and Joe Lando. They were at the last main Kamikaze show, Over the Top. But yeah, no, it'll be good to see them. The next show is looking pretty good at the moment. Luke Douglas versus Zach Walker is a match on the show. If Zach is actually wrestling as Zach, it'll be pretty cool. Not as a cat. He's not with Son Vu Ho in this match, so it makes sense for him not to, but he probably will. Sammy Hughes versus Alex Dean. The Duck's probably not going to be there, luckily. the tag match I've just mentioned. I think there's probably another match that's been announced already. George is fighting someone. Don't remember who. I just remember George's face being on a picture.
It's the Invisible Man.
Is he fighting someone? George Wilden versus Son Fuho. Yeah. So he's fighting that match. It looks a good card so far. Chantel's on the poster. Ronnie G's on the poster. Nate's on the poster. Oh no, Nate's in the match. So. Yeah, so Chantel, Ronnie haven't had their matches announced at the moment, so we'll see what happens with that. I don't think Alex Connors is at the show because there's 55 shows on that flipping Saturday, so I think he might already be booked somewhere else. But it's going to be a good event. But that's the end of Kamikaze Pro Live 45. Overall, as I said, main event was fantastic. There was just a bit too much more comedy than my liking for it, but it is what it is. Like, you can't always have a winning show. Didn't stay for a finesse of out. Sorry. But as usual, like and subscribe. We've got loads of crap coming out. We've got Jeopardy coming out at some point. We've got Wrestle Connect next month, probably now. Wrestle Showdown will be coming back out. We're probably going to do another great British Wrestle Off or whatever we called that in the end.
Mm-hmm.
Got more. We'll have a Breathe review next month. DKW, which we're filming straight after this.
Yeah.
Kamikaze reviews, Kumite previews. We're doing pretty well for ourselves. We're on 1,500 subs now.
Yep.
We're going insane.
It feels a bit like imposter syndrome at the moment.
Yeah. We're killing.
Yeah. I don't really know how we're getting there, yeah. But.
And I will win Wrestle Showdown, which is more important.
I disagree on both counts. I think our sub count is much more high, and we should show love to our subscribers.
Yeah, because they're quite tuning in and how Right Wrestle can get screwed this week.
I don't know what you mean.
Say goodbye, DP.
Goodbye, DP.